So hey guys, welcome to Trading Chandan YouTube channel. Today we are going to see about the post market report of December 2021. So first of all, let's check out the Nifty, Bank Nifty and Sensex performance today. In intraday, the Nifty has gone up to 16,936 and it has gone down up to 16,688. It was a huge move of around 300-400 points, but at last it ended up only with 156.65 points. In today's chart, we can see that the key levels of support are 16,750 and 16,700, and it has a major resistance at 16,950 and 16,800. Same with Bank Nifty, it was also opened up with a gap up and it has gone up to 35,050 points and it has gone down up 34,389.95 points. This was also a huge move of 700 to 750 points, but the point 35,050 acted as a good resistance and it has gone down to 34,607.85 points. It has gained only 168 points even after moving 750 points up and down. So from today, the key levels of support are 34,400 and 34,550. The key resistance point is 35,050, that is the high today, and 34,650. With Sensex, it has closed at 56,319 rupees, and the day high was around 56,900. The day low was around 56,47, and the movement was almost for about 900 points, and it was also opened up with a gap up opening, and finally it has ended up with plus 497 points. For Sensex, the key levels of support are 56,200 and 56,100. The resistance is 56,900 and 56,800. So now let's check the FII DIA data. Today the FII has sold about 1,209 crores and the DIA has bought 1,404 crores. If I'm not wrong, this is the first session after 18 or 19 sessions DIA has bought more than FII selling, and India Weeks is posting about 17.54, which is 7.59% lesser than yesterday, which is a good sign. Now let's check the top movers which move the index with the huge volatility. So on the upper side, it was HCL Tech, Wipro, UPL, Adani Ports and Tata Steel. You can see the current market price and at what point it have moved today. And on the downside, it was Power Grid Corp, Axis Bank, Bajaj Finance, Cipla and SBI. So the top news for today is MapMy India, that is CE Infotech, has debuted today in the stock market with 52% higher rate than the IPO price. But by the end of the day, it has come down to 35% higher than the IPO price and it has closed today. And the second news is about ICICI General Insurance Company. For the first time in India, they are offering with a unique plan, which is dental insurance. And for this, they are tying up with Cloud Dental clinic chains all over India. The next news is about Tata Power. Tata Power has been approved with a 100 megawatt solar project with the MESS plan. It was approved by SECI of Chhattisgarh government. The fourth news is a bit important. Rupee has appreciated about 17 paise against the US dollars, which is a good sign for Indian economy. And the last news is Metro Brands is listing tomorrow. The IPO price was about 500 points, and in grey market it was trading around 490, 480, the same range, which is 10% lesser than the IPO price. We have come up with a new news that IOC's refinery, one of the refinery in India, has been met with a fire accident, and almost 4 killed and 40 or 40 plus people has been injured. So let's check about the breakout or bullish stocks which has been formed today. I always trade two patterns, one is hammer and other one is engulfing. Today there was no proper hammer formed at any of the stocks in NSE. There are three engulfing stocks which looks good for me. The one is RM PropTech, the second one is PT Engineering, the third one is Intrasoft Technologies. For intraday tomorrow, I have picked about five stocks. I have added IOC after this news of fire accident. So the first one is Motherson Sumi, the second one is Cholamandalam Fin, the third one is TCS, the fourth one is Petronet LNG, fifth one is Asian Paints, and sixth one is IOC. So now let's check the charts of Nifty, Sensex and our breakout stocks. So this is the chart of Nifty today, and it has formed almost like a gravestone doji, but not exactly a gravestone doji, but gravestone doji. Let's check out the movement for today. It has opened up with a huge gap up. If you see here, you can check it out. There is a huge gap up, and after that it has a bit resistance there at the day high, which is almost the opening price of previous day. And it has come down a little bit, and again it shoot up a little bit. It was like more volatile but no movement kind of day today. But after that, once the FIA has started selling, it has come down drastically with almost from 16,875 to 16,750 points down. And after that, DA has bought some shares, and it has shooted up 100 points. So finally, it ended up with 156.60. And if you see, there is a resistance at 16,840. And there is a major resistance that is today's high at 16,936. Today's low acted as a support, and that was around 16,690 something. So let's move on to Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty also traded with the same thing. It has opened up with gap up, and it moved almost similar to what Nifty does, and it was a sideways movement for almost 3 hours. And then when FAI came in, HDFC, Axis Bank was moved drastically, and they have made a move of about 34,900 to 34,500. That is 500 points gone after FAI came into the attack. Then it again shoot up once the last minute buying happened. It has shooted about 200 points. The final candle of Bank Nifty also looking not so good. It has been forming a inside bar candle, which is not a really bad sign or really good sign. So let's check our bullish engulfing patterns that has been formed today. The first one is RM PropTech. The stock was listed around 22nd October, and it has formed the upper selfie today, but it was opened the gap down opening. Still it has moved about 7 rupees today, and I expect it can reach at least this level of 197-198. It is now trading at 145. The engulfing pattern has been formed in day frame, so we can go for a short term swing, or probably not intraday, because it is forming upper circuit. Probably tomorrow also, if it forms, it is a good sign. The second one is PT Engineering. This has taken a bullish engulfing pattern at the resistance it has formed before, that is at 212.65. From that point it has filled, it has tested that, and it is forming a engulfing pattern, which is a very good sign that it may go till 260 or it may go beyond that. I'm expecting it to go around 280-290 range, since 300 is a psychological level of resistance. So the third stock is Interest of Technologies, and this chart looks a bit of up movement, down movement. It has formed the support and resistance beautifully, but still I think in this support zone it has formed engulfing pattern, which may take it up to that same 290 285 levels. I always consider round number as big resistance points. If it reaches 300, it is going to come down by 10-20 points. So my target will be around 285-290. So my intraday picks for tomorrow, the first one is Mothers and Sumi. It is also almost formed inside bar pattern, but not exactly. Still it is in the support zone of 200, and it is trading just about 200, so I'm expecting it to move on the upper side tomorrow. The second one is Cholamandalam Investments. This stock also has tested the support zone of 470-471, that range, and it has formed a small green candle. Of course it is a weaker green candle, but it has formed after taking the support, so I'm expecting it to go up by tomorrow. Third one is TCS. Today it was one of the big reason for Nifty to move up, and in this I see a double bottom or W, whatever you call it. So, and it is consolidating. It may consolidate for a few more days, and after that it can go up. But I am expecting FIIs to sell their shares holdings by next week also. Though it was a Christmas New Year week, I don't think they will stop selling. So it may consolidate for another some days, and it can blast up to the 4000 or something. The fourth stock is Petronet LNG, and still it has broken the support zone, but closed above the support zone, so we may expect it to reach newer levels or on the upper side by in the coming days. The fifth one is Asian Paints. I just selected this stock because it has formed a very narrow CPR, and continuously for the 2 days it has formed a green candle, so I'm expecting it to move on the upper side. I may be wrong, but I expect it to move on the upper side. And the sixth one is because of that refinery fire accident news. If you see this stock also, before falling drastically, it has formed a double top pattern or M pattern, whatever you call it. So the markets always give signals for us when there is a reversal, or when there's uptrend, or when there is a downtrend. I like to show something. This is the Nifty daily chart, and I don't know if you can see this. I can see a head and shoulder pattern here breaking at this point, and it has formed and it has fallen drastically from there. Also if you look at this pattern, there is a bearish engulfing pattern which has formed, and it has fallen from there almost 17,350 to 16,400, which is 1000 points. We know this 1000 points is going to fall at this point itself, but still we complained about the market, we still complained about the FII. In my opinion, FII selling is their wish. It's their money, they can do whatever they want. They can book profit, they can buy shares or whatever, anything. Also, at this point, it has formed a dragonfly doji, which is a bullish reversal signal. And it has also formed at the trend line. So, we have a movement of about 17,600 to 18,600, which is also almost 1000 points. We would have calculated this 1000 points also, but I don't know if any other YouTube channel or Insta pages are talking about this. I don't know. So that's it for today, guys. Let's catch up tomorrow with the pre-market report in the morning. Do follow us across all social media. please like, comment and share this video if you like it, and also please comment if there is something that I could improve in the future. Also follow us on Twitter and join our free Telegram channel. We are updating news on daily basis and we are not giving calls because calls make you addictive and it will not let you learn something from the market. So please join our Telegram channel. We are giving instant updates about the news. Also follow us in Instagram and Facebook. Thank you. Please leave a comment.